Cover, there you go. Take any more questions? His hands are all right.
You have to let that settle.
Let's get up a room.
If it's a girl, I want her named Amanda.
Try and find a doctor named Gordon that'll let me.
Like, how long have you two been together? 2 years? That's good.
We still know who you are.
Well, before he asked her.
Do you wish that the franchise would continue?
Well, there's two things that I haven't done. I haven't gotten revenge on Dr. Gordon, and I haven't kissed Shawnee Smith. They're my two objectives.
Well, let's ask you all. Do you all want to see the series come back?
Yeah. Yeah.
James, like I said earlier, is one of the sweetest guys, and just a gentle man, very sweet. And you know, he was a lesson to me in how not to judge a book by its cover. Because before I met him and I read the script, I thought I was going to meet someone with, you know, it's definitely not him, that's for sure. And he's just a very lovable guy, very, very smart. Studied movies like you wouldn't believe. I mean, he's a real film buff. No, obviously a real horror film buff. He's a real fan of Dario Argento and Italian horror. But he can name you every Hammer horror film that's ever been made and who was in it and, you know, the best scenes that he likes and things like that. And he, you know, he and Lee studied in film school in Melbourne. So they're real. They've studied that craft. And so it was a joy to get on the set. And I was on the first day of shooting, I said to him, here you go, man. You know, everything you've done in your life has prepared you for this moment, and you're ready. And he was. And we had a blast. And I miss working with him. So we're talking about finding something else to do together.
Okay. Next question.
Being on set of Saw and seeing all the traps, did you ever find that your mind would wander to think about your own traps that you could set up? Or not in real life.
I honestly, my mind would wonder about how I could get out of this dang trap, go lie down in a trailer if there was one. That's where my mind would wander. No, the last thing you want to think about is traps when you're in one. And like I said earlier, we were really chained to that wall. I don't recommend that. Unless you're really into it. In which case, good on you.
Next question, all the way back.
But not all like you, is what he said.
Is there any item for all of you that you really enjoyed that you kept from the set? Like one item you just fought over or just personally had a pretty long time to get?
Did you say something about phone sex? Happy birthday, by the way.
Oh my God.
What was the question? One item
I have my letter.
Is there one item you'd like to have? One item you'd like to have?
I've tried to steal a few things, but I'm under the surveillance 24 hours a day on that set, so I got no show.
Next question.
I saw recently in the past season of Psych, and I wondered, are those two guys are talking to you?
Okay, and as your first question, yes, James and Dulé, just hysterical. Really funny guy. And that's why I wanted to do the show. I don't really delve into television too much. You know, I get a lot of offers to do it, but I don't really, because I don't watch that much TV. But, you know, when they sent me the script, and they said, here's, watch the show, it's on USA, check it out. I did. And I thought they were just two of the biggest goofballs I've ever seen. And I loved the show. I thought it was hysterical. And I loved working with them. It was great fun. I mean, they're just very light set. Just crazy. And on Saw, you know, mostly it was sort of, James 1 has a very infectious laugh, really infectious. And when he laughs, I tell you, the whole crew would just bust up because, you know, if something went wrong or something, you know, a lot of outtakes of things like hacksaws flying through the other ones supposed to, and we'd all just bust up because it's just so crazy, you know. Dan Heffin, the producer, was the first AD as well, the first one, which is very rare. It shows you how cool he is, because there aren't that many producers who AD as well. And he had a crew with him, a crew of ADs that were hysterical. It's one girl, squirrel. We just do all. I love practical jokes, so we would just do practical jokes every single day to relieve the boredom. And, you know, she would put cream cheese under my car, the door handle. I would put paper in her sandwiches, you know, things like that. And we just kept it going every day. So that was a lot of fun.
Next question.
Yeah. Stemming off of the practical joke thing, I was just actually about to ask about that, because I know that it happens a lot on the set. Which one of your favorite things, like, on set?
I put a goat in Charlie Sheen's trailer. I was good.
Beat that.
I know, really. Where do you go from there?
Do you two have one? A favorite what? Prank that was pulled on you, or you pulled on someone?
No.
Listen, look, this wasn't done on purpose, but in Saw 4, I remember going into the morgue where Tobin Bell's, you know, Jigsaw's body's on the slab. Remember when they take out his guts and they take out the tape recorder?